Hello and welcome to Magic in My Food. This is Jyoti Dalmia. Today, actually, it is a day of celebration. Why? Because I have come out with a recipe of keto bread, and that even with only one ingredient. Yes, just one ingredient and your bread is made. Yes, it is a one ingredient keto bread which does not require any egg, and actually it's a loaf. You slice it and you keep it in your fridge and you can enjoy this bread at least for 1 week. So let's begin with it. So for this lovely one ingredient keto bread or loaf, I just need one ingredient, that is my flax seeds. Yes, I am using the normal flax seeds. If you get hold of the golden flax seeds, nothing like it. And if you get the hold of the flour, that is also good. But don't forget to sieve it. Pass it through a sieve. Just because I am using the seeds, I have just churned it in a mixer and I am passing it through the sieve. Because I need very fine powder. Even if it's market bought, the flour, then please pass it through the sieve to get the fine powder. That is the main key tip for this keto loaf. So I've transferred that flour into a big mixing bowl and now I'm going to add the binder. Yes, it doesn't require any binder except water. Yes, the water will help as a binder in this bread. Yes, I've just added the room temperature water. It doesn't require any hot water or lukewarm water. Just normal room temperature water will work on it. Just mix it up thoroughly and I am going to cover it up and keep it aside for 2 to 3 minutes. Meanwhile, my oven is preheated to 200 degrees Celsius. Now I've taken a loaf pan and I've applied oil over it, and over that I'm putting a parchment paper. This is not required. If you don't want, don't use it, but I love using the parchment paper because it makes my task easier in lifting and everything. So now I'm uncovering the flaxseed dough. See, my dough is properly, it has swelled up, it has absorbed all the water properly. And I'm just going to tap it. So I'm first applying the oil and I'm going to just tap it and roll it into a soft or long log shape, like a loaf shape. I want a loaf shape. So you don't have to knead it tightly. Just remove any cracks over it. If there's any crack, please remove that. And now I'm going to transfer this dough inside the loaf pan. Now I'm brushing the top of it with water. And I'm going to apply the sesame seeds. I love the sesame seeds on top of it. I'm using the black and white one. You can use any one of them. And just press it lightly. And now this will go for baking. I'm baking at 200 degrees Celsius for 45 minutes. Just see it. It should be tight by that time, or make it more 5 minutes. See, after 5 minutes, let it cool down properly. You should give a resting time and then you should cut it. See, after half an hour, I'm just removing it. So easily it's being removed from the parchment paper. I'm transferring it into a plate and now I'm going to slice it. I'm going to make a slice of 1/2 inch. So I'm slicing my first loaf. Actually, since I think so, I'm doing keto from past 1.5 years and I haven't made a loaf bread, and this is my first loaf bread and I'm really super excited to see the result. See, lovely. It's quite crisp. I can make out. I'm cutting. It's quite crisp. I can tell you that. And these breads, you can keep it in the fridge, but it's better if you cut the slices and then store it. So whenever you require, you can just take out one slice and enjoy it. Slice it and keep it inside a box airtight box. See, lovely. Isn't it beautiful? I'm slicing it. Lovely, I'm really happy to see my loaf. You know, I'm happy to see this keto bread. After a long, long wait, I'm able to make a loaf of bread out of keto eggless. What do you say? An eggless keto bread or loaf. I have been making keto eggless buns, keto eggless small breads, but a loaf, I could not even imagine. But here I have actually made a keto loaf. So make this beautiful one ingredient flaxseed flour bread and enjoy your happiness as I am enjoying it. So if you have liked it and enjoyed it, please go and make it. And before that, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and post comments and queries so that I get motivated to come out with all new recipes, more and more lovely keto recipes. And once again, thank you.